serving an underserved and under-resourced neighborhood through the arts. That's the intention of a new theater that opened this month on Joseph Avenue in the city of Rochester. It's called the Avenue Black Box Theater. It's being dubbed the first performing arts venue in the Northeast Quadrant. The theater doesn't intend to only serve, but to also transform a community one block at a time. Joining me at the desk to explain how it can be done is the Avenue Black Box Theater founder and artistic director, Rena Golden, filmmaker London Knight, and Slam High alumni and fellow of the Avenue Black Box Theater, Sharice King. Welcome to all of you. Thank you for being here. So, Rena, Avenue Black Box Theater, you know, people are going to hear black box, black box. What does that mean? What, explain that concept.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's the piece that it's so fun to say, first of all. But people say, well, what is a black box theater if you haven't? You have probably been to one if you've been to community theater. So generally, we call it a black box if it really is just that. A room, you know, with seats, maybe a stage, maybe just a floor, but everything is generally painted black, even though for us, ours is a little non-traditional. We're a black box with a white wall. But it lets you just kind of mute everything, and you don't have to have a set. You don't have to have anything else in the room, because mostly the performance itself paints the picture of what's going on.
Well, this theater is located. I've been there. I've had a chance to walk through before opening day earlier in June. And I was right there in the heart of Joseph Avenue. Talk to me a little bit about what made you say right here and right now, this is the time for this.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, the building really just came to me, actually. I was working with some partners with Joseph Avenue Arts and Culture Alliance, who are doing some amazing work in that neighborhood, really just starting to figure out ways that we can use the arts to transform a neighborhood. I do a lot of programming in the Northeast Quadrant and throughout the city, so it was a perfect lineup. And it turns out that the president of Joseph Avenue Arts and Culture Alliance had this empty building just sitting there. And I came down, me and one of my other partners, one of our residents, Annette Ramos, went down to take a look at it, and I thought immediately this could be perfect because of where it's situated, but also the building is so beautiful. It's so clean. It's like a blank slate, and you know, minimal changes, it could be a black box theater.
Well, on this program in the past, we have discussed the power of the arts and just the influence that the arts can have on individual lives, communities, and so on. And I want to know, I want to ask you both, London and Sharice, talk to me a little bit about how art has challenged you, has inspired you, has given you a voice. And I will start with you, London.
Art has kind of challenged me and given me a voice by allowing me to step out of my comfort zone. For a long time, I haven't really been able to be honest with myself and to explore myself creative-wise. So being able to actually just allow myself to write and to create a film and to do things that actually is something that I want to look forward to in the future, it kind of allowed me to have a voice to interpret for other people who are just like me and people who wants to step out their comfort zone and who wants to explore their creativity in a way. So being able to be a voice for those people and for myself, it was just good inspiration.
And Sharice?
Yeah, for me, I would say that art encouraged critical thinking. I think a lot of times we like to look towards some of the sciences or other subjects as the means through which to do that, but I think that art was really a starting point for starting to engage with characters, starting to engage with different kinds of themes, understanding empathy through other people's experiences, starting to analyze facts about the world and how that sort of contributes to people's narratives about themselves, which turns into art. Those are really important themes that I think came through for me, at least, with my engagement in Slam High and the creative writing program at School of the Arts.
I want to ask, you know, you mentioned London. Arts helped you to step outside of the box, and you mentioned, Sharice, critical thinking and how it affected you in that way. I think some people, there are naysayers, right? And they're like, the arts can't do that. How does it happen? Because we have two personal stories that show the direct impact that it's had. How does it work?
I think it starts with the part that is really personal, and I think both of them are talking about that as well, is just the idea that it's really personal. Art immediately kind of strikes you at a place that is only yours. And then there's a human connection in that as well. I think there's something so inspirational about going inward, right? And then finding ways to connect with others when you want to push out a story or just make a human connection with someone, which is something that's inherent in the arts. There's also the piece that, you know, a lot of folks that are, you know, in spaces where their voices have been marginalized, where this is an opportunity for kind of a low risk way for you to express yourself and say something that's important to you. And it's low risk because you may not have the training to get up and, you know, speak in a platform that's, you know, that really, you know, tells your story or the things that you're passionate about. But the art is kind of it can be low risk in the sense that, you know, it's everybody's interested immediately, you know, when creativity is placed on something. And so then you have the freedom really to express yourself in a way that's comfortable for you and that nobody gets to say how, you know, nobody gets to say, you know, why or when.
Mm-hmm. Before we started recording, all of you said, oh, today we will be at the Avenue Black Box Theater at some point in the day to work and to whatever the case may be. And you mentioned, Rita, you said, we've got kids showing up before the summer program even begins. So talk a little bit about, you know, what can people expect? Because this is not just about bringing the arts, it's also about bringing educational opportunities as well. Mm-hmm. So talk a little bit about what the community can expect.
You know, there's two things that's happening. You know, I come with a very strong vision for what I feel is necessary, you know, in our community. I've been an activist for a very long time through the education and arts and also just community organizing. But I also am in a space where I want to listen to the community. And so when kids start showing up and folks start showing up in the community and saying, hey, I'm really interested. I'm so glad you're doing this. How can I be involved? That's when I really, you know, I really start to listen and say, okay, how do you want to be involved? And then looking at how those ways people want to get involved are demonstrating need and also something that may be missing in the community already. And that's, you know, that's part of the blessing of this space for myself, but also for this community, for Joseph Avenue and Berlin. So what you can expect is socially responsible theater for sure, something that that speaks to the rich culture that already exists but is not always respected or honored. Also, you know, bringing the rest of the country in, because I have a lot of national connections and I'm really interested in finding ways for Rochester to connect with some of the things that are happening on a positive tip all over the country.
London and Therese, you both shared just how the arts have influenced both of you. How do you hope that what's happening at the Avenue Black Box Theater will spread out into the Northeast Quadrant and connect neighbors and businesses and that kind of thing? What type of impact do you want it to have just beyond the walls of the theater?
I just want it to be inspirational to young black lives, especially because, you know, there's a lot of killing and violence going on here in Rochester. The majority is our young black, you know, African American boys and girls. And I just want them to be able to have a place to where, like, they can call their own, you know, and where they can be able to express themselves, whether it's artistically or emotionally or however they choose to, like, you know, be able to be in an environment and not have to worry about, you know, judgment or worry about what goes along with what happened on the outside of that theater. Like, I want them to be able to just feel welcome and feel accepted and just express themselves the best way that they can. So, yeah.
Therese?
Yeah, I just really hope to see the expansion of community, realizing that we all have something valuable to contribute, right, on all levels. I think sometimes there's a disconnect between the older generations and the kids, and I think there are connections that can be made by way of mentorship and other kinds of modes, and I would just like to see that really be exploited in so far as people are working together to write the shows, people are working together to put together the sets, people are working together to help people come to the show, right? In all senses of it. So I would love to see more just community-centered activity and just us valuing each other's contributions to the community and putting on something together.
I think anytime something new comes about, right, sometimes it takes a little bit of time to get buy-in from local residents. How has it been going so far with the Avenue Black Box Theater? Are they skeptical or are they all in?
Oh my gosh, people are all in. I mean, from all walks of life. I mean, from right in that same 14605 neighborhood, 14621 neighborhood, to all over Rochester. I mean, there's been an outpouring of just monetary support, in-kind support. This entire project has been a team, a really, really dedicated team of volunteers, folks who are donating their skills and their time pro bono to this effort. There's folks that, I mean, I wish I could shout out my entire team who's been there, but I do want to say that this is a we project and the community is showing out.
Well, we have to close for now, but a huge thank you to my guests for joining me today. You can learn more. You can also get involved with the Avenue Black Box Theater. Just go to avenuetheater.org.